click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in today's session we are going to study about what exactly is an elastomer or what exactly is a rubber. We use rubber in our day-to-day lives for many purposes, but what exactly it is made up of and how it is different from all other materials, we will see in this session. Elastomers or rubber. The organic polymers possessing elasticity to the extent of nearly 200 to 300% are known as elastomers or rubber. Elastomers or rubbers are such materials which are different than our normal materials. Now, why are they different? It's just because of one property, and that property is known as the property of elasticity. Over here, we have the property of elasticity which makes the entire difference. Every material has some amount of elasticity. Every material, when applied stress, when worked under pressure, will change its dimension. But rubbers have an elasticity which is 200 to 300 times more than my normal material. So if my normal material has an elasticity of X, a rubber will have an elasticity of 200X or 300X. Elasticity is the property which will actually differentiate a rubber from the normal materials. Now, what exactly is elasticity? Elasticity is a property in which if I apply some kind of external stress or I apply some kind of external pressure, that pressure when applied to it will change. That means if I have a rubber over here and I push the rubber, so if I'm pushing it, I'm applying some kind of external pressure or I'm applying some kind of external stress, and because of it, this rubber have the chances of changing its dimensions. Now, what do we mean by changing its dimensions? Dimensions are nothing but shape and size of it. So if I have a rubber and I'm stretching the rubber, that means the length of the rubber is changing. Length is what? One of the dimension of the rubber. So if there is an external source or external force applied to it, that will be change in the dimensions. And this change in dimensions is elasticity. Other components also have elasticity, but not as much as rubber. For example, if I take a solid cube which is made up of plastic and I try to stretch that cube, the plastic will not get elongated just by this minimum human intervention or human force. But if I have a cube of rubber and then I try to elongate it, maybe because of the elongation or the human force, this dimension will change, the length of it will change, the breadth of it will shorten down, and the overall dimension as well as the change in the shape will happen. This property is known as elasticity. Once I remove the pressure, it may come back to its normal point. So when I apply pressure, change in dimension. When I remove the pressure, back to its original dimension. This is somewhat known as elasticity, which rubber has 200 to 300 times more than other normal materials. The rubber gets elongated on stretching and gets back to its original dimension on removal of stress. That is, it possesses the properties of elasticity. Now, what exactly is elasticity? You apply pressure, that means you stretch it out, it will get elongated or it will change the dimension, and you leave it, it goes back to the original form, original shape and size, that is the original dimension. Now let us see the property of elasticity in the form of a diagram. So over here we have a diagram. This is unstressed rubber and you are applying some stress over here. This can be either with the help of the machines or human intervention. After applying stress, there will be stretched rubber. That means over here I have rubber in its original dimensions. As of now, let's take there is human intervention and human beings are trying to pull the rubber out. So if they are pulling it, it will get elongated. If it is getting elongated, what is happening to it? The dimensions are changing and the rubber is under stress. Once there is release of stress, that means stress is released off, it will come back to its original position or it gains back its original dimensions, that is original shape and size. Let's see the important properties of rubber. The first property, of course, the property of elasticity is there, but apart from that, there are many others. Over here, we'll see the property of flexibility. It is flexible to change. What do we mean by flexible to change? If there is human intervention or if there is pressure applied by some machine, it is flexible to the change. That means it will undergo that change, and once that change is removed or that stress is removed, it will again come back to its original dimensions. That is flexibility. The second one over here is strength. Now, why do we say strength? Strength is for rubber. For example, let's say an example of chalk or plastic. If we apply a lot of pressure to it, it is brittle. What is brittle? Brittle means it will break off, but rubber doesn't break off. Why? Because it has the strength, the flexibility, and the elasticity. The next is impermeable to water. That means it will not easily get dissolved or it is not easily soluble in water. And the fourth is high resistance to abrasion. Abrasion is nothing but a kind of corrosion or a kind of decomposition. So if you take a rubber and you put it under atmospheric temperatures, it won't get abrased or it won't get corroded. Why? Because it will not react with anything which is there in the atmosphere and it will not decompose at all. So the first most important property we studied is elasticity, of course, but apart from that we have flexibility, strength, impermeability to water and high resistance to abrasion, and all of these are equally important. So over here in today's session we studied what is rubber, which is the exact property which differentiates rubber from all other components, which is elasticity, and how does elasticity work. We also studied the other important properties of rubber as well. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda.